All right, lap 184, restart. William Byron sitting there. You know, Clint Boyer was leading the race. He picked the outside. William Byron's on the inside. Let's remind everybody what the rules are. So there's a restart zone. Once you get in that restart zone, the leader of the race, he starts a race. It's not the flagman. It's none of that. It's the if the leader restarts a race. If you were to get to that second line in the restart zone, then the flagman would start the race. It doesn't matter who beat who to the line. None of that matters. The rule says that the leader has to restart the race. So, tough call on William Byron. You heard a lot of drivers saying that they thought Clint Boyer checked the field up. Mm-hmm. The speed pointers didn't show that. The speed pointer showed that he maintained a steady pace, but a lot of drivers were making those comments.
So, once again, we have a restart problem here that drivers are playing games with this again, possibly. It's so hard to tell. I mean, you see right here, it looks like Boyer, you know, kept his pace pretty much. It look, you know, William Byron, it's natural, especially as a young driver, to be a little bit anxious in a situation. You're wanting to get a good restart. Once he started, it looked like he tried to come back a little. Then he got run into from behind, and then that made it look a little bit more obvious. But the rule is, whoever you can't fire for. The leader, the control driver, has to fire off first. And, you know, NASCAR deemed that didn't happen there, that Boyer, he wasn't the first one to the gas that William Byron did. So if you go by the rule and the way the law says it is, then that was the right call.
Yeah, and it really comes down to that NASCAR, it's not a whether I can give it back, because William for sure did. He didn't do anything wrong once that happened. He tried to give it back because he'd went the 10 car and everybody else behind him sees him go. They're going to go with him. So he tries to give it back, but NASCAR doesn't allow that. That's not what they want. The point of the rule was, once he went, that was a penalty. It didn't matter what happened after that, whether he stayed in the throttle, checked back up. And all Clint does, really, is once he sees the 24 go, he knows I'm not taking off. Mm-hmm. And we all do that. We've all done that. Once you see the inside car start to launch, you're like, I'm not going. Yeah. It's not his right, which made that even seem worse. But, yeah, that's the biggest thing is NASCAR doesn't allow you to give it back. Once you make the mistake, it's a penalty.
And it looks like Clint does check up, but yeah, Everybody's going this way. Right. If you look at the speed pointers,
yes,
he never changed speed. Mm-hmm. So I you know, I'm assuming the speed pointers are accurate. I don't know why they wouldn't be accurate. So it looked like everybody was anticipating that he was going to take off. And I mean, right here, it looks like he's slowing down because everybody's moving forward. They're all anticipating the start because he's so late into the restart zone. They're like, he's got to be going. And he drug him back. And listen, we talked about William Byron and restarts 2 weeks ago, right? Mm-hmm. And he's going to figure this out, right? He is going to figure it out. It's hard, man. Restarts, being the guy that is not in control, that is the hardest place to be.
And we've seen in the past, Chase Elliott had problems with restarts trying to figure it out. You just keep putting yourself in that situation, learning. You're going to figure out what it takes to get those restarts and ultimately put yourself up front and go win races.
Yeah, those growing pains are no fun, though.
No, they're not fun.
We've all done it.
Hey, motorsports fans, thanks for watching. Make sure you hit subscribe before you go for all the latest news and highlights across motorsports.